You may find this surprising, but getting a cat will not get rid of all your mice. Now, there are several reasons for that. Today, what we're going to talk about is not the cat's performance, but another part of this problem, which is the cat bowl, or as I like to call it, the indoor rodent feeder.
What I've always heard is that mice are instinctually afraid of cats, so you would think that when they smell the cat at the cat bowl, they would completely freak out and run the other way. Well, not so much. The lure of easy food is just way too much for them to handle. Mice are great at keeping under the radar, and they run when danger approaches. That's what they do indoors, and that's what they do outdoors. You can tell that Miss Kitty knows something funky is going on around her bowl, but she is not going to stay there and guard her bowl through the night. If a mouse comes by and she pounces on it, that's okay. But all in all, the mouse made 30 visits, she only made 2. And you have to keep in mind that on this particular night, there were house guests, and these house guests were up making noise and running around through a good part of the night. This clip was shot at about 3 a.m. There was lots of activity at the mouse feeder. It started as soon as people settled down and things got quiet and ran all the way to sun up the next morning. All in all, there were 30 visits to the mouse feeder. Now, there's probably not 30 mice. There's probably a lot less than that. What is happening is that the mice are hoarding food. There's probably a little stash of food not far outside the sight of the camera. Now, that's bad because even once you remove the food bowl, the mouse has a little something back there hidden to fall back on. The indoor rodent feeder is a much bigger problem than, say, a few crumbs that fall under the couch while you're snacking while you watch TV, because the indoor rodent feeder is a constant food source, and it gives the rodent populations time to climb and get out of control. Think about a new bird feeder that you set up in the backyard. At first, the birds don't come. Then maybe one bird shows up. But after a while, all the birds are there and you're buying 50 pounds of bird seed a month. That's exactly the same thing that happens at your indoor rodent feeder. A lot of times, professionals don't tell their customers about this. Then they spend a lot of money killing mice that wouldn't have been there to start with.
If you can get things under control around your indoor rodent feeder, that will go a long way towards solving your mouse problem. But it won't do everything. Mice are still going to come in to get warm, stay out of the rain, escape predators, stuff like that. So you got to get on the outside of the house and find all the little entrances that's getting them in. This is a great example. This loose foundation vent is a highway to the interior house for mice. If you can get out there, find all those little holes, plug them up, you'll be in good shape. That's a challenge though, because mice can come through a teeny weeny little hole. Finding them all can be quite a bit of work. So, but it's worth doing, because once it's done, and the mice won't be coming in every year. And if you do that, your cat can take a vacation. This is Pat the Wildlife Guy with the Wildlife Company. Thanks for watching. Come on back. See us again.